So hi everyone. Today our topic is local anesthetics. In last lecture you must have learned about general anesthetics. So anesthesia means loss of sensation. So local anesthetic drugs are drugs that produce loss of sensation in a local area, in a limited area, compared to general anesthesia, which involves whole body. Local anesthetics produce anesthesia in a limited area. So let's proceed. So you can see this image. It is a very, very old image. Can you see the date? March 1885. Cocaine for toothache, cocaine toothache drops. The cocaine is a local anesthetic. It was one of the first local anesthetic. But nowadays, you already know cocaine is a drug of abuse. You won't get cocaine in the market except for black market. So cocaine is one of the oldest local anesthetic. So it produces anesthetic effect for toothache. So local anesthesia, loss of sensation in a limited region of the body, compared to general anesthesia, which involves whole body. Local anesthetic drugs produce anesthesia in a local area. So there is loss of pain and other sensation, not only pain, loss of pain and other sensation, and also loss of motor functions. So loss of pain and other sensations and also motor functions, but in a limited area. The effect is reversible. The effect is produced by applying the local anesthetic drug topically or through local injection. Applying the drug topically or through local injection. Now how these drugs produce local anesthetic effects? Basically, they block the impulse conduction through neurons. They block the conduction of nerve impulse. That is their basic mechanism. Local anesthetic drugs produce or they block the nerve impulse conduction. That is their mechanism. So, once nerve impulse conduction is blocked, all the sensations can't be transmitted to higher center. So, they basically block the nerve impulse conduction. So, local anesthetic drugs act by blocking the conduction of nerve impulse. How they block the nerve impulse? They block the voltage gated sodium channels. So that is their basic mechanism. They block the voltage gated sodium channels. We will see in detail how this works. So their basic mechanism is by blocking the voltage gated sodium channels. Chemically, local anesthetic drugs are weak base. They are basic in nature, weak bases. Local anesthetic drugs are weak bases in chemical nature. Now you all know, nerve fibers are functionally, you can classify nerve fibers as autonomic, sensory and motor. So different fibers have different sensitivity to local anesthetic. Now autonomic fibers are most sensitive. So when we apply local anesthetic, first fibers to be blocked are autonomic, then sensory, then motor. Motor fibers are least sensitive to local anesthetic drugs. Autonomic fibers are most sensitive. So sequence of blockage is first autonomic, then sensory, and at last motor. So this is the functional classification of nerve fibers: autonomic, sensory, motor. You already know the classification of nerve fibers A, B, and C according to myelination, their conduction velocity. They are classified in three groups, A, B, and C. Now, sensitivity of those fibers to local anesthetics are in this sequence. Type B are the most sensitive, then C, and then A. So, when we apply local anesthetic, first nerve fibers to be blocked are type B, then C, and then A. So, sequence is B, C, and A. In terms of functionality, first autonomic, then sensory, then motor. So, autonomic fibers are most sensitive. Type B fibers are most sensitive. Now, remember, local anesthetic are local only because how they are administered. Because they are administered locally. That's why they are producing local effect. But it is not that true. After applying local anesthetic drug, some of the drug usually get into general circulation and can produce general effects, widespread effect. So local anesthetics are local because we are applying it locally, but still some of the drugs can travel into general circulation and produce general effects that are not desirable. Basically, those are our side effects. So that side effects we will see. So what are the difference between general and local anesthesia? Site of action in general anesthesia is CNS. In local anesthesia, site of action is peripheral nerves. Already name suggests general. So in general anesthesia, whole body is involved. In local anesthesia, only restricted area is involved. Now, problem with general anesthesia is we have to maintain or care for the vital functions like respiratory function, cardiovascular function. We have to monitor and care for the vital function. In local anesthesia, it is usually not required. Now, general anesthesia is preferred for major or big surgeries for which local anesthesia can't be used. For small or minor surgery, local anesthesia is useful. So, these are the few differences between general anesthesia and local anesthesia. Site of action, general means it affects CNS. Local anesthesia usually is only about peripheral nerves by blocking nerve conduction. So these are the few differences between general anesthesia and local anesthesia. Now, local anesthetics are classified into two groups according to their chemical structure. Ester-linked local anesthetic. There is ester group involved. So, ester-linked local anesthetics. They are procaine. Procaine, chloroprocaine, tetracaine, benzocaine. Procaine, chloroprocaine, tetracaine, benzocaine. Another group is amide-linked. There is amide group involved. So, they are amide linked local anesthetic. And most famous one is lignocaine, dignocaine, then prilocaine, bupivacaine, which is commonly used, also ropivacaine, and last is debucaine. Lignocaine is very commonly used, so is bupivacaine and ropivacaine. So, as you can see, in amide linked local anesthetic, the name contains two I's. Lignocaine contains two I's, prilocaine contains two I's. Same in bupiva, ropiva, and dibucaine. Here there is only one I. So amides have two I's. Lignocaine, ropivacaine, bupivacaine, prilocaine, dibucaine is the longest tag. So they have two I. Esters have only one I. Cocaine, procaine, chloroprocaine, benzocaine, tetracaine. Now chloroprocaine is the shortest acting. Dibucaine is the longest technique. So this is the chemical classification of local anesthetic, amides and esters. Now when we compare amides with esters, amides have longer duration of action because they are not hydrolyzed by plasma esterase. Esters are, ester group of local anesthetics are hydrolyzed by plasma esterases. So amides are not hydrolyzed by plasma esterases. So it has, these amides have more intense and longer action. Amides have more intense and longer action compared to esters. And amides rarely cause hypersensitivity. Hypersensitivity is more common with esters. So when we compare amides with esters, amides are not hydrolyzed by plasma esterases. So they have more intense and longer action and they rarely cause allergic or hypersensitivity reaction. Now we will come to the mechanism of action. As we know, local anesthetic blocks sodium channels. Basically, these drugs are sodium channel blockers. Local anesthetic drugs are sodium channel blockers. Now, this is the neuronal cell membrane. This is the neuronal cell membrane. This is sodium channel. Sodium is coming inside the cell via this sodium channel. This is extracellular portion. This here is intracellular. Now when we administer local anesthetic, which are basic in nature, we already seen local anesthetic are basic in nature. So base accept H plus hydrogen plus ion. So at physiological pH there is equilibrium. Base our local anesthetic that accepts hydrogen ion, and that this is ionized form, BH plus ionized form. Now as from the general pharmacology you must be knowing, only unionized form of the drug can travel through the membrane, only unionized. So only this B unionized form can travel the membrane. So when this B comes inside the cell, this BH plus cannot travel inside the cell. So this unionized form travels inside the cell through the membrane. Inside the cell again it will accept some kind of H plus or proton. So this form BH plus ionized form, this ionized form will block the sodium channel from inside. So you must remember, the drug is working inside, from inside of the cell, and this BH plus is the active form. So we can say the local anesthetic drugs are prodrugs. Active form is ionized form. So this BH plus ionized form is the active form, which is blocking the sodium channel. So this is the basic mechanism of local anesthetic. They block the sodium channel. But the active form is ionized form. This BH plus is the active form. Now what happens when we block the sodium channel? As we know, entry of sodium inside the cell leads to depolarization. So when we give local anesthetic, there will be blockage of sodium channel. There will be no entry of sodium inside the neuron. So once that happens, there will be no depolarization. There will be no generation of action potential. And ultimately, conduction of impulse will be impossible. So that will lead to loss of sensation, local anesthesia. So this is the basic mechanism of local anesthetic. They block the sodium channels, and ultimately nerve conduction will be blocked. Now, term is local anesthetic, but when we give local anesthetic, some of the drugs will reach into systemic circulation, absorption into systemic circulation. So excessive dose of local anesthesia can lead to various toxicity. First is CNS, neurotoxicity, that can lead to sedation, dizziness, visual and auditory disturbances. It can lead to convulsions. So excessive dose might lead to excessive absorption of local anesthetic into circulation, which can lead to CNS toxicity. Other problem is cardiotoxicity, heart trouble. So cardiotoxicity will culminate into bradycardia or hypotension or various other cardiac arrhythmias. Particularly bupivacaine is more prone to produce cardiotoxicity, bupivacaine. So absorption into systemic circulation can lead to various troubles or various side effects like cardiotoxicity and neurotoxicity. Also, local anesthetic, when we give locally, there is via injection, there is chance of injection site pain and tissue necrosis and allergic reactions, which are we already seen, more common with ester linked local anesthetic, rare with amide local anesthetic. So major side effects are neuro or CNS toxicity and cardiotoxicity, and cardiotoxicity is more common with bupivacaine. Now remember just that intravenous lipid emulsion is used in treatment of local anesthetic drugs toxicity. If there is cardiotoxicity or CNS toxicity, intravenous lipid emulsion is used in treatment of local anesthetic toxicity. There are various mechanisms why intravenous lipid emulsion is used. There are various hypotheses, but just for time being, remember intravenous lipid emulsion is used in treatment of local anesthetic toxicity. Now another thing, all local anesthetics are vasodilators except cocaine. Cocaine is vasoconstrictor. All local anesthetic names we have seen are vasodilators except cocaine. Cocaine is vasoconstrictor. Now we have seen local anesthetic toxicity. First is CNS toxicity, cardiotoxicity, and bupivacaine is the most cardiotoxic. Now another peculiar side effect is methemoglobinemia, which is caused by prilocaine and some other local anesthetic. What is methemoglobinemia? Methemoglobin, in which iron is in the Fe3 plus form. In normal hemoglobin, iron is in Fe2 plus form. In methemoglobin, iron is in Fe3 plus form, which has reduced capacity of carrying oxygen. So that is very troublesome. Fe3 plus hemoglobin can't carry oxygen. So prilocaine can cause methemoglobinemia. Increased level of methemoglobin, prilocaine. Along with prilocaine, benzocaine and lignocaine, both can cause methemoglobin, but maximum chances are with prilocaine. But benzocaine and lignocaine, both can cause methemoglobinemia. So just remember BPL, benzocaine, prilocaine and lignocaine can cause methemoglobinemia. Methemoglobin is hemoglobin, iron is in Fe3 plus form. Now, sometimes local anesthetics, with local anesthetic, a vasoconstrictor drug is given like adrenaline. So what is the benefit or idea of giving a vasoconstrictor along with local anesthetic? So when we give vasoconstrictor, there will be less chances of local anesthetic drug going into general circulation. So the drug will remain in local area for longer duration. So duration will be more, intensity or intensity of the block will be more. So local anesthetic will be more effective. Plus vasoconstriction will lead to reduced blood in that field. So bloodless field will be available for surgery. So these are the advantages when we give a vasoconstrictor along with local anesthetic, like adrenaline. When we give adrenaline along with local anesthetic, there are some advantages. Prolongs duration of action plus enhances the intensity of the block. The block will be more powerful and it will provide a bloodless feel for surgery due to vasoconstrictor activity. So there are various techniques of local anesthesia. There are techniques, various techniques of local anesthesia. Surface anesthesia. From the name you can see surface anesthesia. So drug is applied on the surface like mucous membrane or abraded skin. Idea is to control the pain. Magic idea of surface anesthesia is to control the pain. Or so that is surface anesthesia. Another method or another technique is infiltration anesthesia. In infiltration anesthesia, local anesthetic drug is injected under the skin in the area of operation. So small area of a body will be anesthetized. So this technique is used for small operations like incision, excision, hydrocele operation, where area of operation required is small. So infiltration anesthesia. So diluted solution of local anesthetic is injected under the skin in the area of operation. This technique is basically used for small areas or small operation when the operating field is very small, like incision, excision. Now bigger area of anesthesia can be achieved by giving a nerve block. So another technique is nerve block. So local anesthetic is injected around the nerve trunks or nerve plexus, like brachial plexus block. Local anesthetic is injected around brachial plexus. So bigger area of anesthesia will be achieved. So this is known as nerve block. Compared to infiltration anesthesia, this nerve block will generate bigger area. So nerve block, in that local anesthetic is injected around the nerve trunks or plexus. One example is brachial plexus block. So we have seen surface block or surface anesthesia, infiltration block or infiltration anesthesia, nerve block. Now bigger area can be achieved by giving spinal anesthesia. As the name suggests, the local anesthetic drug is injected into spine. To be precise, subarachnoid space. In spinal anesthesia, local anesthetic is injected into the subarachnoid space between lumbar vertebra L2 and 3 or L3 or between L2 and L3 or between L3 or L4. So bigger area of anesthesia will be achieved. So this spinal anesthesia is very commonly used for lower limb or lower abdominal surgeries, caesarean section, gynecological obstetric operations. So spinal anesthesia is a very common technique used for operation on lower limbs, lower abdomen, particularly gynec and obstetric surgeries. Now, problem with spinal anesthesia is that it can lead to headache, hypotension, and respiratory paralysis. So these are the trouble with or side effects of spinal anesthesia: headache, hypotension, respiratory paralysis. So we have seen few techniques. Now, different from spinal anesthesia. In spinal anesthesia, you can say the drug is directly injected into spinal cord or CSF, subarachnoid space. Slightly different technique is epidural anesthesia. In that, local anesthetic is injected through a catheter. The catheter is placed in the epidural space. So outside the dura, epidural space, outside the dura, a catheter is placed, and through that catheter, local anesthetic drugs are injected. So area can be either thoracic or lumbar. In epidural anesthesia can be achieved according to the site, thoracic or lumbar. Now, epidural anesthesia is particularly useful for post-operative pain control, because epidural anesthesia is a longer duration in nature compared to spinal. So post-operative pain control, epidural anesthesia is very commonly used. Also for pain control during childbirth, epidural anesthesia. So we have seen various techniques, from surface anesthesia, then infiltration anesthesia, then various nerve block, then spinal anesthesia, epidural anesthesia. So these are the various techniques of administering local anesthetic. Now, this was all about local anesthetic. So let's recap. So what have we learned today? Local anesthetic drugs are classified into two groups chemically: esters and amides. Now, what were the esters? Esters had only one eye: cocaine, procaine, benzocaine, and amides have two eyes: lignocaine, ropivacaine, bupivacaine. Now, what is their mechanism? We know they block the sodium channels. All local anesthetic drugs block sodium channel. How they block? What is the active form? Active form is ionized form. We all know that now that local anesthetics are weak bases. So that weak base form can travel inside the cell through the cell membrane, and inside the cell it is converted into active form or ionized form, BH plus form, and that BH plus form blocks the sodium channel from inside. So ultimately sodium entry will be stopped, and ultimately that will lead to blockage of nerve impulse conduction. Now, local anesthetic drugs can go into general circulation and can lead to various adverse effects like neurotoxicity and cardiotoxicity. And cardiotoxicity is most common with bupivacaine. Remember, cardiotoxicity is most common with bupivacaine. And also we saw methemoglobinemia seen with benzocaine, prilocaine, and lignocaine, BPL. And for treating toxicity, intravenous lipid emulsion is used. And we saw various techniques: surface anesthesia, infiltration anesthesia, nerve block, spinal anesthesia, and epidural anesthesia. In spinal anesthesia, drug is directly injected into subarachnoid space. In epidural anesthesia, a catheter is placed. So these are the techniques: surface infiltration, nerve block, spinal anesthesia, and epidural. So this is all about our local anesthetic drugs. So in nutshell, we have to remember the classification, chemical classification. Two eyes for amides, esters. Mechanism, if we can say in simple one sentence, they are all sodium channel blockers. And active form is ionized form. They produce neurotoxicity and cardiotoxicity. So this was all about our local anesthetic drugs. So from classification, mechanism of action, side effects, and use according to different techniques. So chemical classification, mechanism is very simple. Adverse effect, basically two types: cardiotoxicity and neurotoxicity. And use according to various techniques. So this was all about local anesthetics. Thank you.